Like father, like son in this family is definitely dangerous. Despite the broken bones, this daredevil is evil's boy wonder. But now a biker from London wants to ride Robbie out of his number one status. As Bill McGowan reports, he's dueling with the daredevil.
His name is Knievel, but his first name is Robbie, and he's continuing the Knievel motorcycling legend sparked by his father Evil into the 90s.
I'm going to take the Knievel name out there and keep it number one. I had to leave home at age 17 because my dad wouldn't let me jump any further than 10 vans, and now I got 250 professional shows under my belt.
Running good.
And Robbie's shown that he can more than fill his father's helmet.
It's a definite life risk, but continue to beat death every time. And as long as that happens, I'm happy.
And apparently, Robbie has also kept alive the Knievel tradition of bone-crunching falls.
I've only broken 8 bones compared to 40 or 50 of my dad's. And I'd sit in the ambulance with him when I was a kid and help him shoot xylocaine into his hands. I'd numb them up, you know, for the next jump because they were busted from before. There was a couple times he had to do that, you know, and he'd say, look at me, you know, I don't want you doing this.
But even though Dad said no, when Robbie saw his father's spectacularly successful jumps, he saw an open road before him.
I feel like there's some really big shoes there to fill, you know, and, I mean, everybody knows the name Evil Knievel.
And you're who?
Robbie Knievel.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of your dad, but Evil Knievel, yeah.
Yeah.
How's he doing?
He's doing good. He's playing golf today like you.
Is he?
Now, Robbie's chance has come to motor out of his father's shadow. He's taking part in a jumping competition in Panama City, Florida this Friday night that will pit him against Europe's number one jumper, Eddie Kidd, to determine the world's greatest motorcycle daredevil.
It's going to be one hell of a contest. We're going to be going in excess of 100 miles an hour, and we're going to be landing anywhere from 200 to 250 feet.
The winner will be determined by who has the most total footage after 4 jumps.
Eddie will run off here somewhere.
But his competition is doing more than burning rubber to shape up for the daredevil duel.
Yeah, he has no chance. I haven't seen him train once. And he should lose a few pounds because I'm weighing in around 159. He must be heavier than my motorcycle, man.
There's no way in hell that I'm going to let some guy from North London, I don't care how much credibility he's got on a bike, come over here and beat me.
But the rampaging Englishman believes he can outjump Robbie.
Yeah, I have to take the belt back to England because Robbie's quite big, you know. We call him Chubby Knievel, and I don't think that belt's going to fit around his waist.
I'm either going to fly further than him, or I'm going to do one hell of a Knievel crash trying.
As Robbie awaits to uphold the Knievel name against Eddie Kidd Friday night, the fans have made it known who their favorite is. And on this night, Robbie proved he doesn't need his bike to fly. Rocket Man.